that's the problem. Like, were you making a circular motion? Yes.
I think for background, it's more obvious we're interested in the river. Because, yes, it's looking at the paddle at the same time. But yesterday he noticed this forearm is moving in the cantilever a bit. Independently, as in, here, I'll do what I was doing yesterday.
Understand?
Yeah. Whatever I was doing there, it just moving to my body. And that's what it means by the circle.
Yeah, the only movement there that I would, in my terminology, would be that you're extending your elbow. Okay, so. Oh, hold up with that. So, the, kind of mesh my framework. Yes. So, the, just like that thing on the forehand where there's this position, there's a thing on the backhand.
I'm sure there is.
Well, so if you don't do this, you will do this. That independent motion. Because there's what you're doing is continuing to circle like that. But the pivot point for the forearm part of the circle is at the elbow. So if you lead with the paddle, that's what I'm thinking he's calling perfect. Because what happens is you're doing a circle like this, but what you're doing is you're going like that before your shoulder actually leads the circle. So this is just like on the forehand where if you're just thinking about from here to here, the forehand circle is like this, the backhand circle is like this, right? So that's the circle coming from the shoulder like this. But the thing is, the elbow has to lead the hand briefly before it goes out. If your hand leads the elbow, either, i.e. you extend your arm like this, before the shoulder and the elbow are, if the hand goes ahead of the shoulder and the elbow, then it breaks the circle. It always has to come to the hand. But it's that slow down, stop right there. So right there, when the elbow comes up, then it pulls or drags the paddle through the circle. So you have to, the elbow has to pull the paddle into the circle. But the problem here is you are not, I think the issue is if I say do this at the end, he's going to think that that's this.
That's my before.
Right. So what, but the problem is this is what's causing the tension in your shoulder because you're not releasing, you're not letting the upper arm, the femur, you're not letting it, what is that? Medial. You're not letting the upper arm laterally rotate at the end of the shoulder.
Oh my God.
So this not only does this, but it goes like this and like that. When it gets to here, you're coming up, but you're just holding the paddle. And then you continue to circle like this. But right here, this is what he's at. But he's confusing this with this. This is an extension where you're pushing through the shot. This is what you normally do. And this is strong. So this is incomplete in the circle.
you're not, so when this happens like this, this arm is coming back down. So it's finishing the circle. You go like this, and then this is the part that I'm talking about. Your arm's continuing to circle, but this is twisting out like that. But you can get to here, you do this, and then you go down. You just extend the arm. So the difference is twisting this versus extending this. So when you do this, that's breaking the circle, or at least when you do the same thing. But if he sees you do this, I think he doesn't, I don't know if he has a distinction between doing this, which is the thing to do, because at the same time you do this, you also do this. It's, they both go together like that. And that's the correct stroke. But if you get to here, and then you just start turning to the side and do this, then this is no longer going like this. It's just, see, even though this is doing this, this is still coming around. You just get to here and you stop and you do this, and it's no longer coming around. Now that's specifically what mechanically is going on. But what he is,
it won't feel different what I have like I call this and this.
Yeah. So the problem is this does lay out like what once you've done this, because this is the slingshot effect. It has to come first. So this has to come around and up. It pulls this, then this comes up like this, and as it comes up, it lays out. But the difference is, if I tell you to do that, or if I say, okay, you do this and you lay out, you will stop here and you will just do this. Without this rotation. Yeah. This rotation and this happen together. If they don't happen together, it's not.
So I was doing this.
Well, that's, yeah, so that's what you're doing right now. But you are technically making a circle by doing like this. And notice there's no rotation here at the upper arm. And that's on this side, on the forehand side, that's what this is. So you come back, you rotate this arm inside instead of outside, and then this rotates back this way to hit the shot. On the back end, it's the exact opposite. You rotate inside, and then you come up and hit the shot, the circle, this rotates like that, puts it up. So what you're going to do is, so go ahead and do it again. But the problem is, if you do that, you're not actually going to go into the ball. That's why the circle direction matters. So technically speaking, it's down, back, leave this up and forward, and then go like that. But it's a difficult motion to do. So what you're doing is you're coming around, you're wiping around the ball, which is, I mean, if that's where you have to start, I think on your forehand side, it's a good thing, because you are starting at the right place. And we're developing consistency for the rest. So the other stuff that's going on here with this action and the wrist, but if I were guessing, that's what you're meaning. The problem is on the back end is there's a little bit of sideways rotation, so you actually have to turn, while you're doing this, you have to turn it slightly this way. And when all of this happens, you turn it back this way. You have to turn this way. You almost have to point the tip of your elbow that way, and then boom, and then you rip it around in a circle. But it's complicated because there's a bunch of different ways to do it, and there's at least two major ways to do it. Because the Chinese and the Europeans do this thing very differently. It looks nothing like even
this is different than this.
Yes.
They both feel like circles.
They are. So what is the difference? The distinction between the two is how much you need laterally and medially rotate here. This is the difference between the two. The one way you're not, this is describing a circle, but there's no rotation here at all. And that's what you're doing right now. So last round of the backhands, you're just going like this. And you're just trying to do that hard enough. But the problem is, it's not really a kinetic change, so it's going to stress this. But even if you do this, if you don't do it right, it doesn't do it.
Okay.
So the question is, how much of this and this can you add? So if you take back, it's
here, out, here, out, here. You see how I conflicted the wrist just by doing this? That's what the thing. But the circle can't be sideways. Well, you can. You can go like that. But, this, so it's how much of this do you add? But this and this have to come first before. If you do them at the same time, there's no kinetic change. So there's a slight. Could you do it again? Even though I'm saying this like it's a thing, you, like, one time in like six shots, you'll do this. Right? Because you're like, I mean, it's natural. It's a question of whether this is where we're going or is there something else. I mean, I admit there could be something else you're saying that I'm not. But right now, the difference is for you, you have to know that this is okay at the circle because you see the paddle going in a circle. You can see your, this going in a circle like this, right? And everything's going in a circle. The difference between this and what I would, you know, a higher level player or a professional player is that they're adding this. So everything's still moving in a circle, but you have this rotation which conducts the kinetic. So that's up to you if you want to interpret it that way or if you want to experiment with it and see if you can get that. Like that would be closer to what I would say is. Time you actually tried to time the ball. Everything else you're trying to do is motion. So you're approximating. That time you actually looked down at the ball and said, oh.
Trying not to defend the ball.
So if you can think a little bit of the circle coming forward and not so much out to the side. So when you do that part, think it's coming to you and then going away from you. Yeah, that. You just need to change the don't think of the circle as being side to side so much as back and forth.
Shoulders.
No, I'm brief. I'm making sure.
Sorry, it doesn't touch. Yeah.
No. It activates from here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Is that because?
Okay, I thought you were like, because you said that before, and I was like, okay, I don't want you to hurt your
arm. No, I'm feeling.
Okay, sorry. All right, that's good. Thank you. can also, this is a pen hole thing, so you need to have the grip more like that.
Or don't do this.
You need to close it more. Because you're holding it like you would for a counter hit, and not a front. So you're holding it like this. You're in fact going counter half counter hit. So you need to release the thumb pressure, and you need to be more like that. So here. More like this. It's very critical, actually, is the distinction. Because what you're doing is you're holding a position for a counter hit or a block, and that's not the position for the other. So right here, this needs to be more like this. If you have